Okay, so this is the MobiCam camera. It basically a baby monitor, but it can also act as a wireless security camera. It has both audio and video, and you can communicate two ways. Supports both iOS and Android devices. I'm going to use it on Android. You are basically going to connect it to your Wi-Fi, and then you're going to see and monitor it from your smartphone. It comes with really nice packaging. No damage or any issues or anything. Looks nice, professional at least. It has a lot of different options. You can see it in the manual, but you don't really need it. You might need it if you want, but I found it very simple and the app is very simple enough. So first thing that you do is you download the MobiCam app. This MobiCam app here on Android or iOS. You create an account. You can create an account just the way you create on any other website, like say Gmail. It asks you to verify your email address, and once you do that and create an account, you can log in. Now you can see I'm logging into the MobiCam app. It's signing in. I have signed in. Next, I'm going to connect this. You can see the light is connected. Next, I'm doing add camera. Connecting my camera. Now it's asking me to input the Wi-Fi password. I'm going to put the Wi-Fi password. Next, I'm going to select my time zone.
Get the cell phone close to the camera and keep it still.
Now keep the cell phone close to the camera. That's what I'm doing.
Welcome to MobiCam. Press send sound wave icon. Wait for the successful pairing.
Get the cell phone close to the camera and keep it still.
Click to send the sound wave. See, it is now connected to the wireless network. Okay. It is now connecting to the wireless network. Now we will see. It's green light.
Wireless network established.
Wireless network established. That's what it said. Okay, so after now, it's now saying binding successful. And now I'm going to click on MobiCam. It's saying 30% camera offline. I'm doing this for the first time now. Okay, now we can see we got connected. And it did take some time initially, but eventually what happened was it got connected. You can see it over here. You can see recording. You can take photos. You can take screenshots basically. That is what it will take, screenshot of anything. Talk as well as hear or record. You can hear or open audio and listen. If you have multiple cameras, you can also select this. Let me go back. There are settings like indicator on and off, alarm, video storage recording, video lock, sub account management, time synchronization. I'm not sure how useful they are to you. They are not useful to me. But if you wanted something like this, you gotta have all of these options. Apart from that, I think it is pretty normal. So you can see again, once I click on this thing, it's 97, once again it's live now. So, yep. There is a small lag, I would say about 2 or 3 seconds. But apart from that, it is good. And if you think about it, what is happening is it is sending all of this through the internet and then it's coming to my smartphone. So it also depends on the speed of your internet. I have 25 Mbps internet and it's megabits, not megabytes, 25 Mbps. And upload speed is actually less, I think it's 5 Mbps. So it's uploading at 5 Mbps. So, you know, just so that you are aware of the speed as well or lag as well. I don't think lag is any issue, it's 2 seconds, 3 seconds is perfect. I don't think anything better can be achieved from that. It's just the latency, network latency. Apart from that, everything else is good. Nice quality. Don't have any issues. We did try talking as well. Once I got connected and we paused the video in between a few seconds. And every time what happens is when you stop looking at it and you click on it, it takes some about 5 to 6 seconds to load to 100%. Can see 30% right now and then it loads. It's loading right now and then it reaches 100%, 96, 97, 98. I would say about 5 seconds and then it becomes live. Just so that you know, it's not instantaneous. I also have other cameras outside like Ring camera and all those things which are doorbell. And that much lag is, you know, I expect is there in almost all the apps. So yeah. It comes along with a real large wire. We don't need it because we are going to keep it here right next to the wall. So that is perfect. Nice camera. It does everything that it says. Simple to connect. A lot of other cameras you have to basically disconnect to Wi-Fi, reconnect to Wi-Fi. And if you have multiple Wi-Fi networks like, you know, 5 GHz and 2.4 GHz, it sometimes there is an issue where your phone connects to something else and there is like connection gets stalled in between. But not in this case because it uses sound to transmit your account and password. So works really well. We are very happy with the purchase. Okay, thank you.